This is a study to measure the differences and/or similarities between two methods of providing respiratory support for premature infants between 23 to 28 weeks gestational age. Information from this trial may allow earlier transition to a more preferable method of support. Many premature infants require respiratory support to ensure that their lungs remain expanded and are able to receive enough oxygen. We will compare two methods of respiratory support: nasal continuous positive airway pressure, NCPAP, and high-flow nasal cannula, HFNC. In this study, your baby will receive both methods of respiratory support. Nasal CPAP applies a constant air pressure through a nasal CPAP device, either a nasal mask or short nasal prongs. This helps keep infants' lungs open. Air pressure can also be provided through smaller nasal prongs using high-flow nasal cannula. High-flow nasal cannulas are used in neonatal intensive care units worldwide and have been shown to be safe and effective. However, the amount of airway pressure needed to keep the lungs open remains in question. In order to measure any changes in the lungs during nasal CPAP and high-flow nasal cannula therapy, we will use a technology called electrical impedance tomography, EIT. EIT uses a soft cloth belt containing 32 sensors, similar to those used to measure your baby's heart rate. It also does not use any radiation or adhesives. What are the risks? The risks for babies participating in this study are minimal and equivalent to those of babies born less than 1,000 grams, extremely low birth weight, needing intensive care. Nasal CPAP and high-flow nasal cannula are routinely used in our NICU. Regardless of the respiratory support device used on your baby, nasal skin breakdown is a frequent complication. This has prompted clinicians and investigators to search for alternatives to provide respiratory support for neonates without compromising skin integrity. The EIT belt that is placed around the chest of the baby could potentially result in skin irritation. Your baby's skin will be closely monitored by the study team and your baby's nurse while wearing the belt. If your baby does not tolerate the change from nasal CPAP to high-flow nasal cannula, your baby will be returned back to his or her previous respiratory support and reschedule the study at another time. What happens after I choose to participate in the study? We have specific criteria and guidelines to identify when your baby is stable and it is safe to perform the study procedures. Your baby's physician will be consulted prior to initiating the study. An extra monitor will be placed at your baby's bedside to collect vital signs and respiratory measurements. A neonatal EIT belt with warm ultrasound gel will be placed around your baby's chest to collect lung volume measurements. There will be four study periods for the respiratory support methods. Study period 1. Data will be collected for 15 minutes while your baby is on nasal CPAP. Study period 2. Your baby will be transitioned to high-flow nasal cannula. Data will be collected for 15 minutes, and then your baby will stay on HFNC for the next 6 hours. Study period 3. Data will be collected for 15 minutes during the 6th hour on high-flow nasal cannula. Study period 4. Your baby will be transitioned back to nasal CPAP, and data will be collected for 15 minutes. During the four study periods, a 15-minute video recording of your baby's breathing and interventions will be captured for data collection. The Neonatal Research Institute at Sharp Mary Birch Hospital for Women and Newborns is always striving to find the best ways to care for babies and families, and research allows us to continuously improve our practice. We know having a preterm baby is overwhelming. However, over the years, we've become experts in caring for premature babies. And studies like this are vital to such progress. Participating in a research study is always voluntary. Your participation in this study may benefit babies and families in the advancement of neonatal care. For more information on high-flow nasal cannula trial, please go to www.clinicaltrials.gov and search NCT 037-00606. Thank you.